because you are studying a new topic. It's a totally a new topic. So why not you focus on the topic? Most of the mistake that student carry out will be when a teacher is teaching something on a whiteboard. Okay, I notice 90% of the student, they are busy copy down the notes on the whiteboard rather than try to interpret what the teacher is actually trying to explain. That is the first point I noticed for most. It is very common at the any level. They are more busy to write it down, the notes, rather than focus and understand the concept. Some do come to me and say, I don't really understand what the teacher is trying to teach. Good. That is usual. When you are learning something new, it is very, very common to do not really understand. We are not Albert Einstein to understand and grab the knowledge the moment we study. So, since you know, you are not really clarified with the topic, why not you take an effort, meet an arrangement with the teacher, maybe after the class, and meet the teacher for a short discussion. Especially I notice the problem with Malaysians in general, I'm talking about in general, not offended. They tend to be sitting in the Malaysia, in the classroom, and they are pretend understand a particular topic without really, really understand in deep. To one extent, when the teacher or the tutor asking, do you understand the topic? They just say yes, without not really understand the theory behind the concept. For me, if you think the teacher is the problem, they not really understand the concept of the chemistry, why not raise your hand and ask, I believe the teacher there is paid to teach. So put an effort. Please do not shy to ask a question. Most of them have a habit shy to ask between the classmates. Especially this is a habit for Malaysians, I would say, in general. They thought, when I ask a question, it could be a stupid question and not relevant questions. And you look a stupid among your other classmates. For me, there is no stupid in learning. The one not asking a question is the one stupid, and pretend to be understand is much more stupid. So for me, if you really want to know about chemistry in deep, okay, ask the teacher, am I right? Take more effort, especially focus during the teaching, the teacher teaching. And on top of it, I get plenty of a response in my Instagram. They are keep on saying that I not really understand the topic. Yes, you don't understand. So what is your effort in order to really understand? Do you do enough exercise? Okay, I have after teaching a lot so long in chemistry field, I tend to get some student that, okay, sir, I do not know how to do this of particular questions. Sir, can you teach me how to do? The problem is when I get the student like that, they didn't show the effort of do the question. They just give me the question and they thought I can solve the problem for them. This is very, very, very wrong. Show your effort of doing that particular question and show your lecturer or teacher which part you are actually wrong. Let the teacher to guide you and correct you. That should be the way of study. Then on top of it, I also get some feedback from the Instagram. They say, what will be the right method of study chemistry? Actually, different people have a different method of study chemistry. In my opinion, if you think study individual is better rather than study in a group, why not? Just proceed. And also, if you think study in a group is better than rather than study in an individual, then you proceed. The effort must come from you yourself before you proceed. Remember, I'm studying from my SPM. Until I finish my PhD, am I right? I'm very, very, very firm with my chemistry. What I'm said, if I do not understand a particular statement, I will put 110% to really understand what is the topic is talking about. After this, I will share you how I study chemistry for the past 15 years, and I'm still studying. See you on the next video.